Simon says, and this is my first tutorial. I'm going to be showing you how I make bow tie. There's three ways that I've brought up. This is my first bow tie ever made. It's fit with a bell, and in the back it has a clasp that unscrews as so. And I have over the years perfected this bow tie. We're gonna make this one today, pretty much, and it's clasped with a button and a loop. Now, for those who will be not sure what size they want to make it, this one I have fastened three buttons. One has a size small, you fasten it like so. And then the third one. And the fourth one. And it's adjustable to three different sizes. We'll be making this one today. I'll start with the string you'll need for the main base. So I go one length, two lengths, three lengths, and four lengths. This is about the size you will need. Okay. Now, take it and you fold it in half. And I always keep my two ends, make sure this end stays on this end and this end stays on this end. I'll be starting, this is gonna be like a candy corn kind of ordeal. So I start with my yellow. That's our first. This is going to be like the part right here, these two beads, as you can see. And then another yellow. There we go, we got orange. See how there's two at first, and then there's one, and then two. And then we're gonna go back to our one, so I'm doing one orange. And then our two white, and then one white will make the top part of the center. Now see what we have here? Then we will continue going with two white, one orange, two orange, two orange, one yellow, and two yellows. So here we are with our two white. Is that affecting the noise at all? Okay. And then our one orange. If you sit, she'll just sit. If you want to sit. Two orange. One yellow and two yellows. When you get to this end piece, you're gonna wanna straighten them all out. Make sure the strings are all facing the same way. As you can see here, the string, when it goes through, it is on the same side, both sides. Sometimes it can get crisscrossed in the middle of your weave. So make sure they're all straightened out and pull them tighter together. And this is the first part. Tie this off. and I always tie it a second time. Here we are. Here's our first part of the candy bow tie. Now for our next step, this is going to be doing the next row. I am placing this string through this bead, this yellow bead, bringing it all the way through, placing it down will make it easier to work with. Taking one yellow bead and putting it on your string, then I will be stringing it through this orange bead. String it all the way through. Now, if you'll notice here, we're moving on to our orange beads. You'll see the pattern start to come up through right here. Putting orange on. And then we'll be making the middle with your white. And we've got half done already of that row. Next, your orange. And then your yellow. And make sure you string it or pull it tight. Not too tight. You don't have to pull it crazy tight. Pull it tight and it'll straighten out. How you do the next row, you're going to grab your yellow bead, string it through, and put it through this yellow bead up here. Now you can really start to see the bow tie coming through. Grab your orange bead. String it through. Grab your white bead. String it through. Grab your other white bead. String it through. Orange bead. String it through. Now, to finish off this side, what I usually do is I string through this yellow bead instead of putting a yellow bead already on, and then we'll put a yellow bead on. And this is a very important step for me, and then put it through back through this yellow bead. This will make it so you don't have a bunch of string coming out through the end of your bow tie, and it looks way more neat and uniform. To go back through and finish this side, you are going to string it through this bead up here. Then string it through this bead up here, down here on the end. And it'll be coming out the end of the middle bead. And then coming through, weaving back in with your yellow bead to do your next row. All right, to start this row, just like we've been doing before, put your yellow bead through, put it through your orange bead Oh, not two. Just one orange bead. Then get your orange bead. Just swing it through. Put it through that white bead right there. And now this way, we are going to be working on just this corner over here. So you're gonna wanna swing the string through this white bead up here, rather than going through and completing the whole next row. And then you'll swing it back through this orange bead right up here. Putting on your orange bead. Through that yellow bead. Pull, remember the end, pull the black string through this yellow bead. Because we don't want to just swing that all the way through. You want to pull it through the end, and then it makes it look better on the end with all the string. Again, so there's not a bunch of different strings going which way, every way, to the end of your piece. Grab your yellow bead. Pull it through this yellow bead. And then we have that part of the corner so far completed. Then swing through this orange bead. Not this one, this one. Now you want to swing through that orange bead. Almost done. Put on your yellow bead. And your next yellow bead. Swing it through that other yellow bead. We're done with that corner. Where you're gonna string this, or swing the string through. Make sure it's through this orange bead. This can get pretty tricky, the more strings that have been going through each bead. But it makes it sturdier, I promise. The next one, kind of going all the way down. And I would say stopping after you get through this white bead. All right, now we're gonna start on the other side. All right, so just as we have been doing before, you're going to take the end of the string, which we had tied off in the beginning once you did your base. Pull it through this yellow bead. Our candy corn's really coming together, guys. Grab your yellow bead. Pull it through this orange bead. Grab yourself an orange bead. Pull it through. All right, the only difference between this side and the other side is that we've already got our middle done. So you're just gonna go right on through. And instead of putting on a bead right here, you're going to swing it through the middle bead. Swing it through another white bead. Grab an orange bead. Pull it through. Grab a yellow bead. Pull it through. And you know how this goes. Grab your yellow bead. Pull it through. Grab your orange. Pull it through, just like so, like we've been doing. Now we're going to restart a row so we can get back over here and this way, go in through this middle bead. Then pull your string back through that orange bead you just put on. Grab yourself a yellow bead. And put on your yellow bead again. And we know how this goes. Pull it through like a straight line through all these beads till you reach the end of that white bead. So for your other two corners, don't worry how it may look right now. We'll fix it as it goes along. It takes the shape as you keep putting beads on. I'm going to grab about one length of string. And I usually tie it, I squeeze that string through these two beads. Alright, I swing it through those two beads so it'll be right about here. I tie it off. I don't worry about cutting off any edges yet. They can be used to secure your knots better. Tie them all together eventually. Swing it through this orange bead. Grab yourself an orange bead. Pull it through that yellow bead. And you don't want to have a bunch of strings on the end, so swing it back through that yellow bead and we'll finish it off going the other way. Pull it through this orange bead over here, not this one, but this one. Pull it through your orange bead. Grab a yellow bead. Swing it through. All right, now that corner is complete. We only have one corner to do. We're gonna pull all our string back to the center and through that white bead, like we've been doing. All right. Grab ourselves one more length. I'm always really careful to make sure I always have enough string. I don't wind too much wasting string as long as I have enough and I never have to recut or reattach string where I don't want to be reattaching string. It makes the integrity of your candy a little bit more flimsy and they can break at any given moment. So I'm tying it off like I did before. Pull it through my white bead. Grab me an orange bead. pull through. Grab me a yellow bead. Pull through. Tighten a little bit. Grab a yellow bead. And pull that through. Make sure it's connected. Orange. And then you're gonna come up here, swing through this orange bead. This one, not this one. Pull it through. Grab your yellow bead. Pull it through. We're almost done. Grab your other yellow bead. Pull that through. And start working your way back towards the middle. Now we work on tightening all of these strings that we have made throughout these. Tighten all these strings that we have made and pulled through all the way towards the middle. And you can see the shape really starting to take its form. Some of them, you can just pull on them a little bit, work it out however you want it. If you want it to really be curled, you just pull it more. There we go, that's our base. I'm going to cut this piece off. And cut this piece off. And this is how you tie these off. Pull it through that center white bead, one of them. Take these two. Tie it. Tie it again. Go ahead and tie it a third time, just for good measure. Do the same for the other side. Tie it again. One more time, again, just for good measure. Cut them off. There we have our base done. Next, all we have to do is do the neck part, the necktie. You're going to want about a length and a half of string, and then you're going to pull another length and a half. So about three lengths of string. I always start with my button. You don't want your button. I chose this one. It's a triangle. It's orange. It's glow in the dark. It's pretty cute, and it fits well with the theme. It's a little bit of a Halloween theme, early Halloween. I put it through these strings. Now, a person's neck is usually about 60 beads around, and I'm aiming high here because you never want it to be too small, because then you end up strangling them. Don't want that. Let's start with yellow. We're going to do one yellow going through two beads. All the way down, two yellows, and then we'll start with our orange bead. Put that orange bead on here, going through, and our white beads. Next, our yellow bead again. And so on and so forth until we reach about 30 beads in length. So we have gotten our 30 beads on. Let's decide which side's gonna be our back. I think this side's gonna be our back. Put these beads through this center white bead. And pull that all the way through. And now we'll start on our 30 white or 30 glow-in-the-dark beads again. All right, we're at 26 beads. At this point, you're gonna wanna double the beads. So I'm going to separate the string here, what you would do before. So I'm putting on 2 white beads, and then I'm putting on 2 orange beads. And I'm doing the same for this side as well. So 2 white beads. And then 2 orange beads. And tie them off. Tie it 3 times for a good measure. And then cut your string. Hopefully you have better scissors than I do. And then you have your candy bow tie. And there you have it. That's your candy bow tie with a button clasp. I hope you like this tutorial. It's my first tutorial. I probably have a lot of room to improve on, but I'm pretty proud of this so far.